I want to say right now, I'm not silencing my phone. I'm waiting for a text. I'm absolutely
You're always
not.
Waiting for a text.
Of course
Beverly.
I am. I'm a mother.
Yeah.
I'm a mother. It's very important to stay in touch with your children and be on your phone all the time. Teach your children. Teach your children. Never be out of touch. Never be out of touch. Hello. Oh,
it's amazing that you can communicate that much with a person and not hear them.
Hold on.
Not ever hear them.
I'm gonna sing a little podcast song.
Beverly's not
song.
A listener.
Yeah. I am every podcast. Da 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 da. You understand? Because it's a women's podcast festival. Isn't that wonderful for women? Another industry where you'll make no money at all. Isn't that terrific? Good for you women, really. Aim high.
How is everyone doing this evening? We see a few familiar faces. Excuse me.
Ronna.
A couple of familiar heads of hair.
I don't know where to put my bag. I don't trust anyone.
How about the floor? No, oh, it's New York. You better wear it the whole time, like you do at dinner. We are so delighted to be here.
I just love New York City. It's and I love that we've been asked to participate in this because I feel like we are excellent participators in the world of women. I'm honored.
By virtue of the fact that we are women.
Yep. Yep. Yeah. Know who you are. Know who you are. Feel your inside and know that on the outside, your outside is what your inside says it is. It's what I learned from Laverne Cox. Yeah. And to be honest with you, the human condition must not apologize for itself. If your mind and your heart tell you that that's what your mind and your heart are and do, I don't care where you do your pee-pee. Yeah. You do your pee-pee wherever you want, as long as it's in a toilet and you wash your goddamn hands. I don't care. Wear a diaper for all I care. I don't care. Why does everybody care, Ronna?
I'm not sure. I think they care if it pertains to them, to be honest with you, Beverly.
What do you mean?
My problem is when people who it has nothing to do with get their nose involved.
Yeah.
What do you care what bathroom I use? You're not going in there with me.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
You go where you want to go. We make sure there's a space for people to feel comfortable and safe.
Yeah.
That's what matters.
Sam.
Yep.
Have people met Sam?
Hey, everybody. Hey, guys.
Okay.
This is Sam.
Stand up and look at everybody. Look at you. Come here and sit. Come up here. No, come here. He
hey
used to be a heroin
hey
addict.
It's not accurate.
Is that hysterical?
He was
Sam?
More of a cokehead. He was more of a cokehead.
Sam Kiefer.
Very different vibe.
Kiefer Sutherland. Kiefer Sutherland.
So Sam is with us today in case we have to do any Googling.
I need you to Google a couple. I'm going to need you to do a Google. He'll do it for us.
Because even though Beverly has a phone attached to her at all times, she hasn't quite figured out how to Google
it. It's not that. First of all, Ronna, okay? I know how to operate my phone. The problem is it's a 4, okay? And I'm not eligible for my upgrade. Do you understand?
Oh, I understand.
Okay, so I don't need to explain technology. Now...
There was a very good chance we weren't going to make it here today. I want people to understand. We had such a crisis.
Drama.
Such a crisis.
Yeah.
Beverly is a mother to 2 daughters.
Yes, I am. So I know what it is.
She gave birth to 2 daughters.
To be a woman.
It's not for me to define what a mother is.
Except that I made women.
Yeah.
I mean,
women. They have animals fostering other animals all the time. So I suppose what's a mother? The mother is perhaps the person that raises you.
Yeah.
Doesn't always apply in this instance.
Yeah.
But Beverly is a mother to 2 daughters.
I'm a mother to 2 daughters, 1 beautiful daughter. That's my girls.
1 beautiful, neither of them fully functioning in society.
You know what?
Not quite built for this world, either of them.
Do you want to hear a dirty secret?
That's fine.
Little dirty secret. Twin mothers always like one more. They always prefer one.
Always like one more, of course. You prefer one.
You can't help it.
Look, children are just people.
Yep.
You can't like everybody.
You can't.
Just because there's 4 people living in your house doesn't mean you like them.
Yeah.
I forgot if you have siblings. Do you have siblings?
Yeah, I have 1 brother named Jake.
Older, younger?
Just one?
He's older.
All right, who cares?
And is he a contributing member of society? I just got very sad for your parents, Sam.
What? No, he's fine.
Is he a heroin person too?
No, he's not a heroin person. That's not a thing.
More of a beer drinker?
Yeah, he lives in Milwaukee.
He have tattoos too?
No, he doesn't.
Oh, your parents must be... Thank God.
That's how they can tell them apart.
Huh?
That's how they can tell them apart.
Is that funny? So...
I thought
anyway, as you know, my daughter Lainey, well-meaning...
In Israel, who cares? She'll either make it or she won't. Look, we support the experiment. We hope it all works out. But if Lainey's there when it doesn't, you know, what can we do?
She's on the...
Rochelle, on the other hand, firmly an American.
Oh, Rochelle.
And by that I mean expects everything.
She is.
Except to have to work a full day, yeah.
You know what she does? You know what she does? She has, Snapchat.
Well, she does Lyft, of course. Oh, yeah, she's on Snapchat.
How about that?
Oh, her snaps is so cute.
I can't figure it out.
She's always vomiting. Instead of showing the vomit, she's vomiting. She vomits rainbows or whatever it is.
She makes lemonade out of lemons most of the time. But things have been challenging lately, okay?
She's engaged. Or she was. So there we were. There I was. It was Tuesday night. We came here on Wednesday. It was Tuesday night. I was in my dressing gown. FYI, Frete having a wonderful spring sale right now. So if you're looking for a hotel quality robe or a cashmere pajama set or whatever, this is the time to snatch it up. I was lounging around in my cashmere sweats and packing for my trip. So of course I'd light out my plastic bags and I was vacuuming my sweaters and, you know, whatever it was. Some people don't like to pack. I don't mind packing.
I have had the same duffel bag since 1987. And can I tell you something?
They get a real satisfaction when everything lines up.
They don't make it the
same
way anymore.
People say women can't pack a trunk.
It is
I pack a trunk beautifully.
Durable.
It is so durable. I do more directing of how to pack the trunk.
It was that parachute pants material that they kept on using, and it had the little Le Sportsac.
Well, Le Sportsac's fabulous because they're so light.
But I could just put everything in, and I don't have to worry about it all being in compartments. I just throw it in the bag. That's me.
A lot like a laundry bag. Like a laundry bag.
Hmm?
Like a laundry bag.
Well, with clean things until they're dirty, and then it's a laundry bag, and then I have a laundry bag. I go home with a laundry bag. Winner.
So when you go... So do you just decide everything's dirty when you get home, or have you... I mean, how do you tell it apart?
I can't pack...
When your clothes are in balls, first of all, how do you tell it apart?
What do you mean balls? First of all,
ball it up, throw it in your list books.
I'm not buying anything. First of all, I'm packing for a trip that I'm going to have to take the wrinkles out. I get non-wrinkleable material of everything.
Everything's a non-wrinkleable material? Non-wrinkleable material?
I'm sorry, are you ironing every morning like Edna Turnblad?
I think they call it permanent press.
Huh?
Permanent press, I believe, is what they call
it. Whatever. I know is I'm not a housewife, okay? I'm not what they call a balabusta, they used to call it, yeah?
No.
Okay. I'm not Susie Homemaker, which brings me back to the women thing. The women's movement changed everything. I was going to say for the better, but it's complicated. Okay? And a couple of things about being a woman now. First of all, everything has got a little PC. What's the matter? Don't get crazy. Because you listen to NPR, I can't just say once in a while a little sexual assault is not a compliment. Once in a while? Once in a while? Every time?
There's harassment and there's assault, Beverly.
Okay, either way. Well, there wasn't a difference years ago, but I'm not going to get into it. And the blacks and the Jews marched right next to each other years ago.
Yes, they did.
And now it's more complicated, I guess.
In any event.
Because now all the black people are saying, the poor Palestinians. I don't want to get political. But,
then
it used to be the NAACP and the ADL would walk hand in hand. And it's now complicated.
Ding dong. Ding dong. I said, I'm not expecting anything, certainly not from UPS, because I have the My UPS. I track it. I know when my package is scheduled. Who's here at this hour? Not Amazon Prime. Who's here? I open the door. It was like finding a drowned rat on your doorstep. Except in this case, it was about 5'3½, wearing a Arizona State sweatshirt, carrying all of its clothes in a garbage bag.
May I just...
Which I now know where she learned how to pack. But...
Excuse me, may I interrupt
Rochelle
for one second? Just one second. Fresh
ran on my doorstep.
In fairness, I took 3 Ambien not 2 hours before she supposedly knocked on my door.
Well, she didn't knock on your door first, Beverly. Well, that's the story.
What do you mean? I wouldn't
what
know.
What do you mean? What I'm telling you.
No, I already know what happened, Ronna.
Well, yeah, I don't think you do.
I do know what happened.
No, you don't. They think you decided what happened, and you told it back to her, and she agreed to disagree with
well,
you.
Well, technically, people on
why was she
don't
on my doorstep?
Their conversations.
Did she think I was looking for grease stains in
you
my
can
guest
answer
room?
It. Whatever's pinging, answer it. You should never be without your technology.
She broke up with Joe, the fiance, which I mean, we've been all been waiting for this. Yeah. And apparently she was looking for a warm place to rest her head that didn't have too much clutter. So what was I going to do? I let her in. I made her a grilled cheese. She ate half of it. And she told me the story of Joe, and she said that he wanted to go into some sort of a ride-sharing business with her, and they were going to carpool people to the... I mean, it was the most depressing
Joe
thing I ever heard. And I have to say, for the first time in Rochelle's life, I was proud of her. She said, I deserve better. My mother is a woman in podcasting. I deserve better.
Don't bring my fame into this.
She did not mention 01907 magazine.
Which
she
is had, another reason I'm furious at her. Okay? What? If your mother was on the goddamn cover of a magazine, would you not call or text... Or DM.
I don't think they get 01907 in Phoenix or Tucson.
That has not, that's
or
not the point.
Wherever she lives.
Well, if she were. Okay, I'm not. You know something? Again, you don't have daughters, Ronna. Okay? And they're very complicated individuals.
No, I have one son who's fabulous.
Oh, boy. Yeah.
He's so fabulous. It's so fun to be in New York because I sort of do Jordan's New York when I'm here. I walk the streets of the Village downtown, which is fabulous.
I
think to myself, I bet Jordan's has gone for
he's like a
place.
Goth. You know what a goth? You know goth, they look like a vampire.
And you sort of,
all the
I
blood.
Mean, you can map. I mean, he should do like an app. He should do like an app that says, this is where you get a cup of coffee, and this is where you get the best socks.
Can I be honest with you?
This is where I wait in line for sneakers, or whatever it is.
His clothes are
he's
so
in Portofino.
Tight that I feel like.
He's very slender. He's built like his father. His father was very athletic, Dr. Bob. Tan all year, that sort of, like a George Hamilton, but a little lighter. You know, you're not worried that he needs a mole check every 5 seconds. But Bob had that olive complexion, and he was an athlete. He was naturally athletic guy. Oh. Tall, broad shoulders, slim waist.
Ronna.
Taciturn.
Ronna.
Taciturn.
Ronna.
Yeah.
I want you to know something. I just figured it out. I figured out what...
You should have seen
inanimate object.
Bob in tennis whites. You should have seen Bob in tennis whites. And he had a Porsche at the time, which was so cute. I mean, it was like he was holding on for every second to his youth. Yeah? What were you going to say?
I figured out what animated inanimate object Jordan is. It just came to me. Does everyone know what I mean by animated inanimate object? For those of you in the podcasting world, you may want to figure out what your psychological gift is and then really expand on it and share it with your audience. Raise your hand if you're a podcaster looking to get into the industry. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's
oh, you're
no
to
one.
Raise your hand?
That's
okay.
No one, Bill.
Liar.
Not one person has raised their hand.
Okay. Yeah, one.
Oh, there's two in the back.
One man.
Two
we
in
have the
back.
Wrong festival. Okay. So anyway.
2 minutes ago, the door was open to everyone.
Yeah, I know.
You were accepting everyone 2 minutes
okay,
ago.
Okay, be quiet. So anyway, an animated inanimate object, I have a gift for being able to tell.
Yeah, it's part of your synesthesia.
Yeah. Like what men would be if they were Mr. Peanut. You know what I mean? Except they're never Mr. Peanut because Mr. Peanut is Mr. Peanut. But if
but
they were like
but who
a
do you
typewriter,
think is Mr. Peanut?
Huh?
Who do you think is the human that is Mr.
Will
Peanut?
Will Arnett. But anyway.
Fair enough.
So, but no, like, you know, like a typewriter, an old-timey telephone that walks along with
wearing
eyes.
Wearing white gloves.
And eyebrows.
Yeah, yeah.
So your son, Jordan, is an erect pierced nipple.
Is it a male nipple or a female nipple?
Tiny male nipple. Not a child's male nipple. A twinkly nipple.
You know what I think, Beverly? I think you don't like the fact that your daughter knocked on my door, Beverly. That's what I think. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a pass on this. I'm going to give you a free pass.
What pass? Why is it going
to let you... I'm going to give you the opportunity to regroup and at a later date, tell me what Jordan's animated and inanimate object is.
May I try again?
I don't really think... As far as I know, the person has to be standing in front of you in order for you to use your gift.
I'm imagining him.
That's very interesting. People have asked you in the past, if I sent in a picture, could you tell me what I am? And you always say, no, you have to be in front of me.
Can I tell you something? My gifts come from God. And I don't try to tell God how to play his games.
Speaking of gifts from God, we're going to give you a gift, which is we're going to do a little advice for our audience. Which is something that we often do on the pod.
Can you get me a piece of paper and like a...
From where?
She wants to doodle. She's nervous.
I feel like doodling.
Sam, you don't have to do that if you don't want to.
Yes, you do. Go get a Sharpie.
No, wait. No.
No,
I don't know if there's a razor blade in that notebook or what.
Oh, yeah. No. Give me that.
No,
give me that.
Philadelphia lesbians want you to doodle in their book. She's going to want that back. She's going to want that back. It's her calendar.
Oh, I'm going to change some of the phone numbers in here.
Have we got the advice here?
Okay.
Terrific.
Hi, Joanna. Joanna contacted us and tried to play it cool, but she's a fan. So anyway, that's Joanna. She's very cute.
Why don't you give those to me since you're not a reader? Of letters. There's more than three here. Beverly, I'll give this to you as a fellow while I read this. What's your opinion of Elliot Gould? You ever see MASH?
Come on.
Come on, Larry.
I'm drawing a penis in here because I know you don't see them regularly. Not because she can't, because she's a lesbian.
Okay.
I know her. It's okay to laugh.
Where's Phoebe Ah?
We're all okay to laugh. It's okay to laugh.
Where's Phoebe Ah?
Who?
Phoebe Ah has a question for us.
Oh, hi Phoebe.
Hi, how are you guys?
Oh, we're terrific. How are you?
I love you.
You guys are such a delight. Thank you.
Oh, we do know
I
that.
Think you're
Thank
wonderful.
You.
My question is, I am a black woman. And hunting.
I don't see color.
Thank you for
thank
identifying.
You.
Thank you for identifying yourself to the people at home.
I'm a black woman in search of a Jewish husband. Any tips on how to snag one?
Pick one. Are you kidding me? They'd be thrilled. You're the last thing they want to bring to their mother. That's perfect. No, honestly, why can't you go? They have a section on J-Date for people who aren't Jewish who are looking for Jewish men, don't they, Ronna?
It's my understanding, but it doesn't apply to me, so I'm not sure.
Well, I don't... What is that supposed to mean?
If I went on, that's not a box I would tick.
Okay, anyway, so then you answer.
What? That's what's going to stop you from giving advice?
No, I just
I
gave
don't
my
know
advice.
If J-Date takes people that aren't Jewish.
I just gave her my advice.
Which was what? They'd love to have you?
Let me tell you something.
That's
Can
not
I tell
advice.
You something? Here's what I want to tell you. I think it's a wonderful match, and I'll tell you why. Did you see Roots?
She wants...
Yes. Yes, I have.
You know what I... You know, the best part of Roots for me was recognizing that my people had literally nothing to do with what happened. Nothing.
Yes.
I'm sorry, I don't believe that.
What do you mean you don't believe
it? I just don't believe
that. We were
in
Anatevka trying to get the fuck out of our own problem.
I strongly believe if you did a little digging, you'd find a couple of Jewish brokers involved, Beverly.
But I can tell you something. That's
what people eked out a living where they eked it out. I'm not blaming people for what the previous generations did. I'm just saying I don't think our hands are clean.
Okay.
Okay.
What I can say from that and what I learned was that these are peoples that truly do understand each other. And I wish for... What is that supposed to mean?
It's not to you. I'm just reading these.
Oh. Yeah. And I'm suggesting that perhaps on your J-Date profile, you suggest, I know you had nothing to do with the root situation.
Okay.
Let's start on a good foot together.
I like that. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're not going to have a problem if you want to meet a man of any kind. You're very, very cute.
Also, the Jews took an active part in the Dutch colonial slave trade.
What do I care about the Dutch?
Or wait.
Dutch colonial. It's exactly what I just said.
Yeah,
they traded
slaves.
We're talking about Curacao, are we not? Which was the first Jewish community in the Northern Hemisphere. Excuse me. The oldest congregation in North America is in Curacao. You can look that up if you want to.
My deepest apologies.
And that's, I'm sure... And you probably know the Lakua. And I can guarantee you they passed right through there. It's gorgeous.
Oh, yeah, they did a lot. Looks like a lot.
They did they not?
Yeah, it was thriving.
I'm so tired of playing Jeopardy with everybody. All right, so here's my favorite one. I would just want to, first of all, tell this person to go screw themselves. Where'd they go? Elena E. I love my Jewish mother, but she often gives me too much advice and micromanages my decision. Any advice for lovingly breaking free? Go fuck yourself, Elena. Hang up the phone if you don't like what your mother has to say. And then send her flowers, because you were wrong. All right, here's one of my favorites. Bianca B. Where's Bianca? Let's hear it, Bianca.
Ask it.
You want me to read it?
I'll ask it.
Okay.
Is it okay to go to work with wet hair? My mother says absolutely not. But in the summer, I don't want to blow dry, and I don't like to shower at night.
It's a very good question.
Thank you.
It's an excellent question.
I am glad we're getting it out in the open. I have very handsome people on my side, Beverly. Look at that guy. Are you an attorney? I'd like you to be my attorney. I know, but you look like you'd be a great attorney or something. That's the attorney you'd want. Like, oh, meet my attorney. He's adorable. Yeah, yeah.
I would say if you don't work for Bill Cosby, it's fine. He loved them wet. Why is everyone upset? It happened a very long time ago, and now he's getting his comeuppance. Thank God.
Women to have their hair wet. That is true.
He likes to dip them in the shower, then have them asleep. I mean, that is... Give me... What a sicko. But I would
that
say...
Those were the two nicest things he did to those women.
Was...
Have a shower and take a nap. Those were the two nicest things he did to those women. He ruined all of those women's
lives.
He's a criminal.
Yeah, yeah, he is. He's.
No, you can't go to work with wet hair. What do you do for a living?
I know. I work at Us Weekly magazine.
Oh, what do they care?
How are they still employing you? Do you work in the mailroom or in a closet or something?
Pretty much.
What's your position?
I'm a fact checker.
Oh, well. That's why nobody said anything, because they don't want to do the job.
Yeah.
So what do you call Justin Bieber's manager up four times a week and say, is it true he wasn't wearing underwear?
No, I just suggest the word allegedly almost every day. Just could we throw in a couple more? Allegedly.
Well, I'll say this. I think there's something deeper at work here. Have you always wanted to wear your hair wet in the summertime, or is this new since you started this job?
Always. I never want to blow dry my hair in the summer.
I know how you feel. That's how I feel about my pubes. Years ago,
whenever the Jews and the blacks match side by side.
They did. I'm not going to get into it, but we know. But
get into what?
Which one?
That's what I'm asking.
Hang on. I'm suggesting that after a shower, what feels better than being dripping wet from every hair on your body and walking around and letting the earth blow you dry? Let the earth blow you. Be blown by the earth.
Save that for a Sunday. Okay? Look, you're either an adult or you're not. Are you a professional person who goes to work and acts like an adult?
Trying to
you
be.
You also don't have to wash your hair every day.
You're not trying to be, is my point. Okay? Get an air conditioning unit. Plug your if you have enough voltage in your Manhattan apartment. Plug your air conditioner in next to that, or do it at the gym where it's very cold. Anyway, they keep it cold there. So you don't have to worry about fitzing your brains out. You might have to get up 20 minutes earlier. I'm sorry, dear. So that your hair dries before you go to work. If you want to drip dry like Beverly, you got to get up a little earlier.
You're right.
Well, go to the drive-by. They have very reasonable rates on package deals.
Not anymore.
For people that care about fashion,
drying
your hair is out now. A blow dry is out.
And they'll put
anyone in the girl in the fifth row.
What do you work at the
dry
bar? They'll hire anyone now.
You have to go natural now.
They will get anyone to just rake that roller brush through your hair. It doesn't matter whether you're happy or not.
It's
all rough on the head.
My feeling is you're not happy in your job, and that's the bigger issue. I'm serious. This is your act of rebellion. You don't love the job. That's
that
my
true?
Opinion. You do not have to respond to that since this isn't a public forum and you'd like to keep your job.
It
I
is
would
a
imagine.
Public forum. It's completely public.
Okay. I said that.
Hurry up.
You want another one?
Yeah.
Start looking for a new
you're
job.
You're welcome. Bianca.
I'm going to let you read this.
Hi,
one.
Barbara. How are you? One of the Barbaras, Barbara Roseman.
I'm going to let you read this one, but then she can respond. Where's Kate Steinberg? She can't be trusted with the microphone, but you could give it to her anyway. She's right there in the back.
All right.
This is a great question.
Oh, I see. I have to tell
her, you want to ask it? Should we let her ask it?
No. Dear Ronna and Beverly.
Dear Ronna and Beverly.
My 11-year-old daughter has been feeding the barn.
Feeling the burn, you fool. You sat there and laughed like you understood the question.
Because
like
you want to know
understood
why?
The question.
I thought feeding the barn was an expression for masturbation. Feeding the barn. I thought it was like something that
she'll be doing that next year.
She's
she'll
11.
Be feeding the barn next year.
After her bat mitzvah.
Does she ride horses?
No.
That's feeding the barn, isn't it?
That's where you usually feed the barn
for
the first time.
And Beverly, my 11-year-old daughter has been feeling the burn very strongly and hates Hillary despite wearing proudly her feminist t-shirt. How can I convince her to be with her? With love and gratitude from your wisdom.
For your wisdom. Sorry. Oh,
so can you tell me a little bit more about this though? I mean, what degree does her dissatisfaction take with the former Secretary of State?
She doesn't have a real explanation. She said
she has a crush on a boy in school that likes Bernie.
I don't know if she has any crushes on any boys, honestly, but she said I like I'm not ruling it out. She said I like his vibe, Bernie's vibe. And then when Hillary was becoming closer and closer to the presumptive nominee, she said, ugh, I hate Hillary.
She can't vote.
And I said, you better get on board. But I don't want a Hillary hater in my house.
Fair enough. But she's an American, and Americans are independent. Mm. And we're all registered as independent. You understand?
No, we're not. We are.
Democrats. We're not all registered as independent. I
my own opinions.
In fact,
and my
few
opinions
people
are my
are
opinions.
Independent.
And I have opinions, and you have opinions.
Yeah. Beverly wants everyone to earn her vote until the very last minute.
Fair enough.
She likes to. She wants to leave it until the very last minute. Yeah.
So. you know. Well,
Beverly, as a mother to daughters, since I don't have daughters.
I have daughters.
What do you do when you disagree with your daughters on something important?
On everything.
Do you think I should let her just hate Hillary? I don't feel
well, but what should let her hate anybody?
Take? Does she just say I can't stand her?
Stick her in a gorilla cage.
Is it more complicated than that?
She's not graffitiing Hillary faux pictures.
But I mean,
tagging.
What does she say about her?
She just says, I hate her. Yuck. There's not a lot of subtlety to her.
She doesn't say she's a closeted lesbian and she doesn't deserve to be president.
Nothing along those lines.
Or she and Huma have got something going on. Or I wish she would release the emails that she deleted. Or she doesn't say anything like that.
It's very general feeling more than specific issues, I think.
Honestly,
I mean, I
think she's immature. I think that's very tough. Because, you know, she's wrong, of course.
Yes, I know.
But, I mean, what else is she wrong about? Probably everything she wears to school every day.
She's a pretty cute dresser.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's
a very good student.
My guess is she has a crush on a boy in her class that likes Bernie. And that's really depressing from a feminist perspective. Much more so.
She said most of her friends like Hillary.
What about blogs?
Oh, so she's a contrarian?
She might be.
Read blogs. Yeah.
She might be. Yeah. I hate to take up so much time.
Or the news.
I would probably just ignore her.
Yeah.
Or the computer.
I think that's always good advice.
I mean, in all things.
Yeah. No,
If I had a daughter, that's how I would deal with it.
Just ignore her. I think that's good.
Or just if
she wanted to wear a dress I bought her, I'd probably give her a compliment.
Can I tell you something?
If she didn't, I probably wouldn't compliment her.
Right.
You give your daughter the world.
Okay.
Give her the goddamn world. Whatever she asks for, you give it to her. She says, Mommy, buy me that. You buy it.
Should I let her get her hair straightened? It's
whatever
very curly.
She wants.
No, don't let her get her hair straightened.
I have a niece named Shira, okay, who has triplets, two boys and a girl.
We never told
Phoebe
where she could find a Jewish husband. We never even told her. Phoebe, you could find a Jewish husband easily. You're absolutely gorgeous.
My niece, Shira.
I mean, I bet you're smart because you're here.
Has one daughter, Daisy.
None of them want to marry their mothers anymore. They used to want to, and now they don't want to anymore. So
developmentally delayed. And
all right, we should
move on. I have to tell you,
at
the end of the day, the daughter is still heads and tails ahead of the boys. Okay, they're morons.
Excuse me?
The two of them, the moron twins. Carsten and
my
Brayden.
My son has never missed a birthday. He has never missed an anniversary that my husband and I celebrated. He has never missed a Jewish holiday without sending me a card. He sends me flowers once a month. We have lunch together. We get our hair done together. We go shopping together. We're on FaceTime. We're Skyping.
Ronna.
Do your daughters do any of those things?
No, but I just figured it out. He's not an erect nipple. Do you know what he is?
No, Beverly. Tell me what he is, and tell me what he is in 4 minutes.
He's a dollhouse plate saucer turned upside down. It's pink and rigid. And there's a pencil eraser cut off and on top of it.
So it's a nipple.
No.
You're describing a nipple.
No, I'm not.
A pink plate upside down.
A mini one.
Convex.
Baby
with
tiny.
A pink eraser on top of it.
And then
sounds a lot like a nipple, Beverly. Understand? You understand? Convex, like an upside down plate.
Okay, this is from direct from G-D, this gift, so I'm not gonna, I will not apologize.
Should we bring out our guest?
Now I'm drawing a vagina. Yes, of course. We have a guest on the podcast, because that's what we
thank
do.
Thank you for your questions, by the way.
Yeah,
I
thank
hope we
you
give
very
you some
much.
Decent advice.
By the way, although we don't get to all of your questions here because...
Have you ever said to your daughter, don't be such a bitch when she says something like that? Just to see what she would do?
You never do that. You'll psychologically harm her.
You
don't
say Brett. That. I'd be curious what she'd do. Just to see what she'd do.
Ugh, please.
Don't be such a bitch.
Did she mention, by the way, that Joe, her ex-fiancé...
probably shut her up for a little while.
Did Rochelle mention that her ex-fiancé is 59 years old with two children already who are her age? Did he mention that?
He's
Did
her she ex. That? Why are you focusing on him?
Because I'm just saying she's made very poor choices despite my having given her anything she wanted at any time, which was what a mother should do.
So you're advocating your parenting style or you're retracting
advocating, and then I'm saying after a certain age they do what they want.
So anyway, why bother parenting them at all?
I can't right now. So anyway, I was going to say, if your questions, you have burning questions, you can submit them to shalom@ronnaandbeverly.com.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
And then we'll talk, yeah. We can answer them in a later
Every
podcast.
Every once in a while, we'll
Not
answer
this
them.
Right now.
Yeah. Yeah. And yes, to whoever this, not a G, you got to send out those thank you notes. You just do. You have to send them out. And nobody likes to write 100 thank you notes, but you have to do it.
Yeah.
She got married, she sent half of them, and then she got exhausted and didn't send the other one. She wants to know what she has to do about it now, and you have to say, sorry for the delay, ha ha ha. Something charming about why you're not the most ungrateful person in the world, and then get to the thank you, and you know, and also nobody needs a long thank you, just make it personal.
It okay. just occurred okay. to me that these two are using a tour guide book from 2004.
I'm sure nothing has changed.
All right. So we're going to get ready
Ladies
to bring out
gentlemen.
Our guest, but we're going to take a quick pause while they rearrange the stage,
oh, that's true,
and then we'll
yeah.
talk to you. Where are the handheld mics? Joanna? Sam?
Yep.
Bring, oh, Ricardo! Oh. Hello!
Hello,
Ladies
Ricardo.
And gentlemen. What? Ricardo. Jesus Christ, it wasn't working. That's
they
Ricardo.
They told us about Ricardo, but they did not tell us he was going to be like okay. a flamenco dancer.
Ricardo.
Amen.
Okay, so Ricardo,
Hi,
reset
Sam.
The stage. Yeah.
How are you, Sam? You look very handsome.
I'm good.
Excuse me, that's an old flame of mine in the back.
What are you talking
I
about?
I didn't expect you, Sam to be here.
Which Sam? Oh, Sam. Oh,
yeah,
hello.
I did not expect Sam to be here. Huh. An old flame of mine in the audience. Why don't we do one more of these before
yeah,
we...
Yeah, do another one.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
One more.
Blah, blah.
That's
gay.
Terrible.
I'm gay. It. Nobody loves me. Okay, here's another one.
Everyone
How
loves you.
How do I get
you?
People to like me more? Okay. No.
Everyone loves you. We love you.
No, we do. But I mean, this here's what my boyfriend... Okay.
I am not throwing away my shot.
My boyfriend isn't paying as much attention to me as he used to. How do I get him to treat me like the beautiful special queen misspelled? I'm so tired of that nonsense. No, the special, beautiful special queen I am. I don't know if this person wants this to be anonymous or not. They did put the name on it.
Well, then read the name.
Zach A.
All right.
Not oh. to... Not to be confused with Jack A, apparently. For the people at home, this is a real quick one to answer. Zach just opened a fan with a flourish. I think the answer is there isn't enough attention in the world for you, Zach. So you can either keep starting new relationships and enjoying the honeymoon period or stick with what you got, because I don't think that needle's going to move much further. Are you cute? Are you wearing a Beyonce Formation World Tour t-shirt?
I ba-ba-ba-ba-ba lemonade. I loved it.
Is that your boyfriend sitting with you with the matching
no,
sunglasses?
No, this is my best friend.
Why do you have matching sunglasses? Did you both stop
we
at
do.
The same gas station? It's a coincidence. Where did you get them?
I got mine in Montauk.
And?
From Pride 2015.
What is, where's that?
That's everywhere.
Yes, I
he
understand
it
it's he, everywhere. That's why I'm asking.
I understand what Pride is for the gay people. They do a big celebration
I understand.
For gay
it's like
people.
A, it's like a
Mardi Gras.
Block party. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
You got them on the street?
Yeah,
of course.
And you got yours in Montauk.
They were handing them out.
Yeah. All right.
One more because we have to bring out our guest. Our guest is juicy.
All right, well, this we can just bring her out now.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, have you seen...
Let's switch seats, you and I, for fun.
Aren't you sassy?
Well, I tried to do something spontaneous for a change. You got very nervous.
All right.
You accused me of not being spontaneous.
Well, because, Ronna, you're not as free with yourself.
But I just offered to do
sexually.
Something free, and you got scared.
I mean, as far as I know, I just know that my bedroom habits are...
You're wearing a black brassiere today,
I am.
Right?
It's not
that
a
That never happens.
Third
Did someone
love.
Die?
What do you mean?
Is that you're not... I know that when you're in mourning sometimes, you wear a black brassiere because you like to wear color everywhere else. So you don't ever like to go out of the house in black.
As a matter of fact, Ronna,
yeah.
after our Brooklyn shows last night,
yeah.
it was, I found myself in a predicament and this was the only option. So our guest
So you went home with another woman and took a brassiere from her house?
Yes.
Our guest is a podcasting queen.
And she was, we'll talk about that, but she's not
she
just...
She is now the reason that we even started doing a podcast.
Yes, she is.
She said to us, you have to do a podcast.
Yeah, and we said, what's a podcast?
Oh, wait a minute. It's these two in the corner from last night.
What do you mean?
Looking a little worse for wear today, ladies. No? It's not you two? Yeah. Whoops. Oh, it's you two. Moving on. I thought it was the participators.
No, the participators are passed out in an alley somewhere. Trust me.
In any event, she is absolutely the person that got us into podcasting. She's the reason that we're standing on this stage today. She has a fabulous podcast of her own called How Was Your Week?
Yep.
Excuse me.
Yep.
She was totally on the forefront of all of this stuff.
Yep.
And she has a terrific show on Hulu. Yep. She's going to tell us all about it because the second season is about to come out.
Yep.
And she's in a gorgeous redhead, which is not easy to do.
Yep.
Pardon me.
Yep. Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, Julie Klausner. Yep.
Klausner, where the ba 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 ba. Julie Klausner. Now that's
this
true.
This gives those people a chance to get a better look at you.
Yeah, I understand. Yeah. Now let me say something, Julie.
Look
Klausner.
At those fun shoes. Are those cute?
They are really cute.
They're like totally Machu Picchu. Totally Machu Picchu.
Yeah.
Oh, does your cat chase you around with those? Yeah.
She's got a cat named Jimmy Jazz that she's always posting little pictures of, and honestly, he is one adorable cat, and I'm a dog person, 100%. Dog.
If you like cats.
But let me tell you something. But Julie, so you got us, you know that you started this nonsense with us. Is that true? Do you know that?
I do. I remember helping
Ronna
you guys
shopping
get
for a
equipment and...
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because you were doing How Was Your Week with Julie Klausner.
Because we're one of my first guests, and you ranked your favorite Holocaust movies.
Oh. Do I love a
Schindler's
Holocaust
every time.
Movie.
Schindler's every time. The show
boy,
I actually is
the
number
boy
one.
In the striped pajamas was the wild card.
I just, yeah.
That's Beverly's favorite.
Absolutely. And
I
love,
think Europa is oft overlooked, I'll say that.
Yeah, it wasn't on your list. Yeah, you guys couldn't agree on that.
Oft overlooked.
One.
But Showa for sure has to be.
Life is beautiful,
the most
and
work
I'm
went
Italian,
into
and I'm in a concentration camp. Life is beautiful,
and
I'm in a camp.
I think we agreed we hated Life is Beautiful.
I loved it.
What's your favorite Holocaust movie, Julie?
I'm going to go, like, you know, old school, Schindler's List, I guess.
It is really.
I mean, you
it
can't
holds
go
up.
Wrong with Schindler's List.
Well, you can go wrong about 12 minutes before the end of the film.
What happens 12 minutes before the end of the film?
Schindler's List is a terrible ending.
Oh, you mean where they're, like, alive today
this
and then
pin,
they go to the
this
graveyard?
This pin,
and,
all that business.
And it's
are
in
you,
color.
One more pin.
Like a
the
really
film
shitty,
before
like,
that is terrific.
Pleasantville, out of your
like,
mind?
Like, it turns into color at the end.
I need you to move a little closer because we're so loud.
Every frame
and I want to make sure
of Schindler's List is precious and beautiful.
My favorite is when they find that little boy in the outhouse.
Sometimes when I can't sleep and I'm just turning around the channels and I'll start watching at any point.
Oh, anytime
it's just like
it's on,
Working
I'll
Girl. Yeah. I'll start right in the middle. It doesn't matter.
If it's on, I'll watch it. Same
this
with
is my
Gladiator.
Favorite part. I know this part. Isn't that fun? So,
Julie, you have been so busy since the last time we saw you.
When was the last time I saw you guys?
A million
it's been
years
a long
ago.
Time
it's been
ago.
A while ago.
Yeah.
But you have a
you have your own show?
Yes.
Difficult
it's coming out
People.
July 12th. Thank you. Season 2. July 12th.
And it comes out July 12th?
July 12th, yeah.
And you're probably doing a lot of press talking about it and everything else. So I don't want to ask you like the boring same old questions, but some of them I have to ask because For me, I want to know. I want to know.
This
you
is
know.
Your podcast. You can ask anything you want.
Yes, I can. Boy. Yeah, fuck you, Julie.
I don't think she was stopping.
Okay, so here's the thing. To be honest with you, do you write every single one of those shows?
Yeah, I write them. I write them.
But it was your
idea. I write them with Scott King, who's my showrunner, and then we do have like rotating writers in the room with us.
Is that true?
But
and
then
what,
I
you
do the
punch
first
them up after they're written like a whole...
I do the first draft and then Scott and I talk about how it's messed up and then we do it again and again and
so,
again and
so
then we
work.
Send it to someone to punch it up and then when we're on set we sometimes have
so
to
So what
still
is the rotating writer do? What's their
working
role?
Too hard.
They're they're more than muses.
Yeah.
But we did have Cole who plays Matthew on the show.
Oh, he's very
in the room for we just kept renewing his contract cuz he was so fun to be around and he would eat a lot of candy around 3 p.m. and come back with
very
like a little boyish grin.
So the three of you would sit there together and you two would sort of say, this is what we're thinking, this is...
Well, it was sort of like a conversation between me and Scott and like people would jump in when we get stuck.
Chime in a little.
Yeah, yeah.
So
break the story.
Why
yeah,
did
fun.
You pick such a hard career?
It sounds like a lot of fun.
You could have done anything. You're so pretty. You could have been a model.
When did the sunglasses come down?
Can I tell you why? It's so goddamn bright up here. I'm not a performer like you. And to be honest with you, I'm concerned because that you could, it's like, you know, it's just a
why do you seem so sad? I turned over, you're wearing right, your
you're she right, is a woman in podcasting. She's sitting here telling us she has her own show that she writes almost every word of and she stars in. And you're sad.
Work.
What's
you
going
know,
on?
I don't know. It's a lot of work. And I just,
I you think women are overwhelmed, they're taxed, it's too taxing?
It's a lot of work. I mean, it's very good, but you can have, I hope you have, do you have an assistant? Do they get you an assistant?
Yeah, I have an assistant.
You do?
Yeah,
do you
not right now, because we're in between things.
So what? I hope you worked her to the bone.
What's the worst thing you have asked your assistant to do?
What's the worst thing? I told her to find a cleaning service that could deal with the like musty smell in my apartment, which is like, it's a challenging thing to Google. So I put her on that.
And did you get the magical elves?
Yeah, no, I didn't. I got this guy named Rick and he came in and now it smells bad in a completely different way.
So he didn't identify, you know, I gave a hug to a guy earlier today who smelled like an Italian sub.
I
hugged
that
guy
that
too.
That
it was not.
He was.
Pleasant.
It smelled like sadness.
It was
sadness.
Not pleasant. It was coming out of.
It was not
every
good.
Pore in his body. He was. There was pepper.
He wondered why he
juice
was unhappy, and I
every pore in his
had
body.
A few answers. Sam.
Yeah.
Can you Google must see what comes up for musty smell in the apartment?
Okay.
What did he identify the smell?
No, he just came in and he goes, yeah, it's stagnant in here, and then he just started spraying chemicals everywhere.
So oh, Julie, work. Come on.
It didn't work,
but
no.
How long have you been in that apartment, Julie?
A long time.
Yeah.
A long time.
And how long have you had the smell?
6 months or so.
Oh, it's new.
Yeah, I changed Jimmy's food. We'll see if that works.
Do you think Jimmy Jazz brought something in and it's living on dead under a radiator?
I don't think it's a dead smell. It's just a, like, open the windows kind of smell.
Well, it was winter.
Yes, it
six
was.
6 months ago.
It was.
And now it's not.
Now it's not. Yeah, now it's not.
Can you pay me whatever you paid Rick? I just solved your problem.
And then I called Rick the next day and I was like, Rick, you made it worse. And he came back in and then he made it even worse. I don't
well,
know why
Rick
I went back to
a little
the source
musty.
Of the problem.
Little musty. Did you have any sort of that seems like a real set up for a porno.
Yeah, it seemed a little porny when he came
yeah,
in.
Yeah, I bet
realized,
it did.
I realized
where's
that
your
I set
musty smell?
Just walked
I'll
right
look between
into
your legs and
very
see
like
let me ask you.
You know what, Beverly?
What kind of porn do you want?
All kinds. All kinds. Let me ask you some everything you don't remember
she's
when pornography...
She's a voracious porn watcher. What, Sam, did you have something?
Dehumidifier is the most common thing that pops up.
Do you have a humidifier?
I have a humidifier. I don't have a dehumidifier.
You need a dehumidifier. We may have solved
just
this.
Just put it next to the humidifier. Whatever.
I was
going to
say, like, does
when
that
did
rule
you get,
out the humidifier?
Yeah, when did you get the humidifier?
Oh, years ago. I need it because I'm on, like, a high floor and it gets very dry.
Oh, yeah. You
do you think
to...
you need a new humidifier?
I don't think so because I clean it every week.
You do, with how?
With palm olive
the filter?
And yeah, yeah.
Hmm.
I do.
Do you have a cleaning lady?
Yeah, but she's terrible, and I'm paying her too much.
I have to
fire her because I can't pay her less.
I understand. I have
and
the
then
same,
I get yep. Sometimes I get gift bags from like events.
You give them to her.
Last time I gave her
the only problem with that is they
like
come
a
in
camera.
Wearing the perfume that you got for free that you hate that cheap.
No, it's not. It's not. It's not that. Her name is The Gooch.
Look,
I gave her like a camera that came in a
gift
bag.
Does she look like Forrest Whitaker?
No. No, she looks like Marcia Gay Harden. And I gave her like a... I gave her a camera that came in my... Because I was like, Malguchka, could you clean behind the refrigerator? And she looked at me. And then I gave her the camera and she goes, okay, Julia.
Oh, so it's a stick and carrot
situation. It was a barter situation,
yeah.
So let's talk about difficult people for a minute because it's absolutely hysterical. So if you
have people watching this program,
it's on Hulu.
Thank you.
And from what I understand, that you knew Billy Eichner. Now, did you know him because you were just hired out of the blue to write for Billy on the Street, which is absolutely genius, or did you know him beforehand and then you got how did you become friends with
him? I was a fan of his Man on the Street videos, but he'd been making before Billy on the Street, and I kind of wrote him like a fan email, and we became friendly and talked about doing a show together, but it didn't materialize in that particular way. And then he called me when he had a real show and hired me.
Oh, okay.
So he had the show. You guys didn't pitch the show together.
No, we never got to that point.
Okay. He said, they want to do something with me. You want to do it together.
No.
When
about
Billy
on
the Street.
The
game show,
then
he called me and
that.
Said, this is going to be on the air in 10 minutes.
And then
right
difficult.
Oh, I see. That's fabulous.
You wrote that for
and
you.
And then
Billy.
You said, let's do this together.
Yeah.
Was there ever a point where someone said to you in the world of network, I don't know anything, but who said to you, well, we love it, but it would be so great to have Andy Dick and Julie Louise Dreyfus play these parts. I mean, did they ever make that suggestion?
No, I never heard that one.
But was there ever a question that
I would watch 5 minutes of that.
But you know, we'll love it and we'll do it, but we don't want you in the part.
No, I didn't have that experience, luckily.
So you had a very good development process where people didn't say.
I did. We went in knowing what it was.
What are you talking about?
It just feels like this feels very raw.
Can you imagine if someone in network television
said, a little bit like when somebody said to you,
who's going to play Ronna and Beverly?
No, we're doing the we're doing the tennis tournament at the club is I was going to say. And I'm thinking about you as my doubles partner. But instead, I'm going to get Ronna or whatever it was.
It was especially hurtful. Yeah. I mean, to be honest with you.
Because we want to win or whatever the... I mean, I'm just trying to think of an analogous situation.
It was my turn on the spreadsheet that was posted at the club. And my number was up.
An elective tournament and yeah. Anyway.
That sounds like a very parallel situation.
Well, you think you got the pat and then you don't. Okay. Yeah. You think you got it locked up because your name's on the spreadsheet and then put somebody else in there.
So can we talk about Andrew Martin for a minute?
Sure.
You know who Andrew Martin is?
Yeah. Brought his son to the Tonys with her.
Did she really?
Yeah, her handsome son.
She looked gorgeous.
Did you go to the Tonys?
Fabulous. No, I didn't watch it at home.
I loved it. Beverly loved it.
Thank God for the Tonys.
I love the Tonys.
Really made a terrible day better.
What did you think
better?
Of James Corden?
I thought he did very well.
Very well.
And did you like him before that?
No. But I walked and I came in and thinking, and he really impressed me. Yeah. He gave 150% throughout the whole time, and he was very good.
I can do a James Corden impression.
Rarely out of breath.
Do you want to hear my James Corden impression?
Tina.
I never saw one of those carpool karaoke videos, but I've seen screenshots and I get the gist.
Yeah.
And there's one where he's shirtless with the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
What?
I've gotten no fewer than like 3 screenshots from friends.
Oh, that sounds horrible.
The worst
Mostly
part of it is
of
he has
chili
a mic
peppers.
Stuck to his bare...
I still find the Red Hot Chili Peppers more distasteful than that. If I had to choose between being in a car with James Corden naked and being with the Red Hot Chili Peppers, I'd choose him.
He's in the front row. There's the seatbelt, there's the mic, and then there's the, like, girth.
Moves. Too much.
Hairless. Moves. Hairless.
What is the challenge now? Because you're going into your second season.
Yes.
So did you feel like you did the first season and you sort of got away with it? That you had enough ideas and you got away
with
it?
No, you do not.
Or do you feel like going in, you feel like you're hitting a stride
moguls.
In the second season?
Like moguls on a beautiful Killington ski slope. Icy ones. Icy smooth moguls.
Talking about someone in the audience's nipples.
No, not at all, Ronna. Pay attention.
What are you talking
about? You said, I hear everything backstage. I hear everything. That's a direct quote. I hear everything. You said when the stage manager said 8 minutes, and I said 8 minutes, you said, I hear everything. What I was saying was...
I wasn't talking to a guest and interviewing them and paying attention to them at the time.
Everyone here is a guest. Everyone is a guest. People are equal. I don't see color. You understand? okay? Everyone is my guest. You're all welcome to sit in my lap and be cradled in my arms.
I was asking Julie if she felt like she's hitting a stride with the second season or if it's difficult.
And I was telling that man that his man pecs are like moguls at Killington. Please continue.
Should I address both at once? Or yeah. Is there a question? I forgot the question.
Choose your own adventure.
I'm just having a great time making the show.
So, the second season, was it harder or easier because you'd already had that?
It was easier because we had more time to write it.
Is that
true?
But
then once we went into production, it was as hard as
anything. How long do you take to shoot the entire season?
Like 2.5 months, 3 months.
Because
Billy has to go to do Billy on the Street. Yeah, this year it was 10. We cross-shoot all of them. It's the same director.
Are people asking you to be in more things and do more things now?
Not even close.
Is that true?
No. Not, it's very, because people assume that I have my own thing.
So you're too busy.
That's what I tell myself.
Well, it is true.
And not that I can't act. But no one asked me to do their thing.
Julie.
I know.
You have your own show? No, it's not sad. You have your own show.
Yeah. They're asking Lin-Manuel Miranda to do every goddamn thing under the sun.
Mary
Poppins.
And he's
busy every night.
He's doing Mary Poppins.
And he's doing other things, Ronna.
Like what? 2 minutes on Amy Schumer?
All right. You know what? I'm not getting into this with you. Lin-Manuel Miranda. So let me ask you another question. And
Beverly's more, a bigger Lin-Manuel.
Are you
going to
do more? How was your week? Because
I did one a couple.
You
weeks
did about
ago.
What? About American Psycho.
Yeah, I did. Then I did another, but then not to bring the house down, but Orlando can.
I
wanted to like give it a minute, and I was going to do one like Sunday morning, and then
I understand.
But I'll do another one.
Did you actually enjoy American Psycho the musical?
I loved it.
You okay. did.
I loved it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What do you think about that Ben Walker? Speaking of,
I saw him in Heather's.
Speaking of moguls,
I saw him in Heather's.
He did
musical.
Me the favor of becoming an 11. I mean, overnight, and it was a pleasure to watch him in his underwear for 2.5
American.
What is he? What is she?
It's closed anyway.
She's
here.
Telling those people who Ben Walker is.
That book was.
He's very handsome.
I mean,
do you think he's charismatic as a performer?
Very was aroused much so. By the book.
Very
he's
much
a little
so.
Bit. He's a little bit enigmatic, I think.
In
he's a little had
was,
to read.
In this role he was. In the past, I hadn't. I sort of thought of him
I
as
saw
a
him
puppy.
In Bloody, Bloody Andrew Jackson
yeah, so
many
did I.
years
I
ago.
Saw him in Heather's. Did you see Heather's?
No, but he was very,
no one
very sexy.
Yeah. Yeah. So good.
Yeah. Not my type, as opposed to Dow, which was just like, am I becoming a cougar, or is he just like...
Well, he's about the same
irresistible.
Age as you. He's not
No, but I feel like my attitude towards his hunkiness is a little cougarish. Like, I never used to be
You're
one of those women
young.
That's
Stop
like,
it.
What
you
a hunk of man.
What you, why not?
Who else do you have that reaction to?
Yeah, who's your hot man?
I haven't really. Like, in the
Who
past, I've just been
hunks?
Attracted to...
Okay.
Like a young Steve Buscemi. You know what I mean? Like, this
you
is
like
very new for me. I usually like men that look like they,
do you
they
like
might
Gollum
be dying.
Too? Or... Are you an Andy Serkis and a Gollum fan as well?
I'm not. That's no Serkis I'll be attending.
Gollum is a young Steve Buscemi.
May I start a campaign? A campaign, please. A campaign. I'm starting a campaign. Get Andy Serkis on How Was Your Week?
No.
Yes, please.
He's not welcome.
I want to hear
none
it.
Of, nope.
I want to hear that
Absolutely
interview.
Absolutely not.
It's like
I'll
two different
a green
species
screen
talking
before
to
I interview
each other.
With Andy Serkis.
Do you want to hear it? I mean, what's he going to say?
Nothing.
He does so many other characters. I'm not sure what he is. So you want to have Gollum or you want to have Andy Serkis?
Yeah, who do you want? Who, me?
You made the suggestion.
I want to hear just the two... It's like listen. It's like a fish interviewing a frog.
That doesn't sound so unlikely.
Forget it, Ronna. You know what? Forget it. Anyway.
Well, I mean, they live in the same pond together. It's
okay,
not
shut
that
up,
unlikely.
Not a freshwater fish.
They would
fish.
Know each
not
other.
Not a freshwater fish. No, a freshwater fish does not live in a goddamn pond with a frog. I mean, if it does.
Yes, they do.
I mean, a saltwater fish. Forget it, Ronna. I'm not getting into nature. So, Julie, but so Steve Buscemi and then two more. That's normally.
Like a James Spader, Andrew McCarthy kind of thing.
Wait,
yeah.
So that's two different.
Nobody
that's
since
different
James
flavors.
Spader and Andrew McCarthy.
Oh, I think they're the same flavor. It's like vanilla and like
no,
honey
not.
Vanilla.
John Hughes flavor. The John Hughes asshole flavor.
Like the hippie kind, not hippie, preppy sort
Preppies,
of blonde.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Oh,
well,
yeah.
This explains the American Psycho fixation.
Well, there you
same
go.
Era.
The less than zero connection.
Same era.
Yeah. Maybe, yeah.
So
maybe.
No, not dirty. Even the less than zero connect, just I that mean, it was the 80s.
Maybe American
Psycho. Well, I mean, I came of age in the 80s.
Yeah.
So.
He was like Bill Cosby before Bill Cosby. American Psycho.
Who was?
American Psycho. Because he would.
He was a fictional. Don't tell people that. That's not exactly
also,
true.
Also, he's a fictional character, Bevel. Patrick Bateman is a fictional character.
There was
he
drugs.
He was not like Book House.
There was drugs, and there was a lot of sexual
Bill
activity.
Cosby's an actual person. He may be a soulless person, but he's a person.
Pudding. I understand. I would have been one of those girls if he had asked me to come up for a drink to talk to me about my career in a heartbeat.
Oh, you mean when you were pursuing a career as a comedy writer early on, Beverly?
No.
When you were 19. Those women weren't all comedy writers.
And you took the bus to New York. Remember those days?
Of course I remember those days. We all had dreams. Be dreamers.
Beverly was a coat check girl.
You'd have lunch at the counter at Neiman Marcus.
Why not?
I don't know.
Dreamers. Oh, I dreamed a beautiful dream. What's the Anne Hathaway song? I dreamed a beautiful dream in the miserable French countryside. Remember that? She was terrible in that movie. Just terrible. So many close-ups. Les Mis is supposed to be seen from here, not here. You know? Am I right? Did you like Les Miserables, the movie?
Sure, yeah. I liked it okay. Yeah, I thought it was, I enjoyed it.
You
I
did
saw
not.
It in the theater and
no.
around Christmas time.
What?
I was impressed by
but
it.
But did you
I
like the the regular show?
Sure,
and
yeah.
then you liked the movie too?
I remember thinking, okay, they did a good job with it. Yeah.
Is that true?
Yes.
What do you think of Hugh Jackman? It's just a question.
I think...
not just in that
I
film?
I think he and his wife make quite a couple.
Because she's very much a lesbian and he's so gay. I agree. 100%, yeah.
I don't know if she is a lesbian. But
yeah. I don't know either, but I love... seeing the two of them photographed together and his producing partner, who's always with him, who's very good looking, is another person I'd like to see him photographed with.
He's like a sperm.
How so?
What do you think of him as an actor?
Like a sperm, like a wiggly sperm. He can do anything and slip anywhere.
I don't think he's... I haven't seen him in that much because I haven't seen like those Marvel movies, but he seems good. He's not the most versatile. He's definitely
Wolverine.
A song and dance man. I've heard he was fabulous in Boy from Oz. And
have you ever been with a woman?
No.
Never?
Sexually?
Yeah.
No.
Not even your lips on her lips?
No.
Not even a kiss?
Not even a kiss.
And you're not interested ever? So the opportunity must have come up before, Julie.
Yeah.
And you'd put the said no...
Well, I didn't say it like that.
But you didn't want, you just, no? You
it changed the subject.
It?
Yeah.
What about for the right woman? Not for a relationship, but I mean just for fun. You're fun.
Am I?
Beverly,
yes.
is this woman's initials BG?
No. No. I like black girls.
Phoebe's looking for a Jewish partner.
Look, my night last night was what it was.
Yeah, Phoebe,
if it doesn't work out with the men, Phoebe, Beverly's available. Yeah.
Of course. Now, let me ask, did you see Roots? Did you? Why? I don't know why it's so funny. You know, it's a very important part of our history, Americans.
I've talked to you maybe like 5 minutes since I've gotten here and you mentioned Roots 3 times.
I found it very powerful. There's a man named Kunta Kinte who had a very difficult time, and it's very important, and I have to tell you something.
What everyone should be talking about, which I know Julie's interested in, is OJ Made in America. Are people
that
watching this?
That is unbelievable.
Are people
so
watching this?
It's the documentary, not the
That's the next thing you need to do in 2 seconds. No, not the... not
American
the,
Horror...
Not the Cuba Gooding Jr. Too. One.
The one Ryan Murphy made with Masha Clark,
no,
Clark,
the one
Sarah
that
Paul's
Ezra Edelman
wonderful.
Directed... which is on ESPN. This is the one we're talking about.
I know, I'm saying both are good. Both are good.
Well, they're really not.
What's the matter with you?
They're really not both good.
There were some moments in that.
Which one? Cuba going,
I'm OJ!
There were a couple of things. One was Lance Ito telling his wife, I got the job, which was really funny. And then there was one where Johnny Cochran's literally sitting at his computer going, if the gloves are too small, no.
Yeah, but
I like scenes where people are trying to write something.
But did you like the Masha Clark one? The
she
episode?
Was fabulous.
What's
oh,
her name? Sarah
fabulous.
Paulson. She should win every fabulous. Goddamn award.
Fabulous.
But okay, but let's talk
now
about the one
she has a type.
What do you mean? Oh, she's a lesbian.
She has a type.
Yeah.
Well, that's
yes, she
something.
Does.
She has a type.
Cherry Tree.
Cherry Jones.
Cherry Tree.
Holland Taylor.
Cherry.
She has Taylor. A type.
Are they the same?
Would you put them in the same category?
Older lesbians? Yes.
Oh. Well, I mean, no, but that's just older women. She likes older women.
She does.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Much older women.
The gray triangle.
Yeah.
I like
you.
But not me. Young, beautiful, Nubian women.
I suppose that's
women.
True.
There's maybe that's...
I'm not suggesting that I'm just saying there's a spectrum. And everyone knows it. And anyone who doesn't is a schmuck. Now, going back to...
O.J. Made in America.
Fabulous.
Wonderful.
Fabulous.
You have to. It's on
what are you loving? What are you specifically loving so much
the
about
cultural
it?
Context of the history of racism in Los Angeles and the you know, just going up to the L.A. riots. Ugh. And it's fascinating.
They really...
It is so
And I didn't know she was 18
when they met.
When he met
Oh, yeah,
her.
Yeah. Nicole Brown.
And that he hit her on their first date.
Listen.
Ugh.
Or... It was role
and I hadn't
play.
Seen, yeah. I don't know about that,
I
Beverly.
I don't think so.
I don't know about
I
that, Beverly.
I don't think so, Beverly. Unless he was playing the role of batterer.
I'm just saying I've gotten hit on many first dates. There's no record of me saying hit me, but I did.
Getting spanked on your tush is not the same thing that we're talking about.
Getting
here.
Potched on the tushes.
Yeah.
But she was very, the whole cultural.
The point is, it's a very interesting contextually.
Oh, lot of footage.
And it does.
And that Hertz ad I'd never seen in its entirety old woman's going, go OJ, go. Yeah. Which was what people
All
said
the
when
white
he was in
people
the
are around cheering. They're showing everybody how it's okay to cheer for a black man running through an airport. It's a very strange campaign. I really understood the documentary. It's about...
No, absolutely riveting.
That
and there is so much footage.
Anthony Weiner documentary.
I have not seen that yet. Is it good?
It is so good.
It looks so painful.
It's one of my...
It looks so painful.
It is. It's one of my favorite...
Weiner.
I mean, it rivals the Metallica documentary when it comes to someone
Sam.
With so little self-awareness who let someone with so much access into their lives.
Say hi to Barbara. You didn't even say hello.
Why do you think he did that?
Malignant narcissism.
But why do you think
grandiose?
Better question, why do you think she let him do that?
Wait, which
I think
part?
She
what
remains
about?
An enigma.
Huma.
Oh, wait on the Weiner. Can we go back to OJ for two seconds?
What if you're going to say something
I am.
Real.
What happened? They don't talk about what happened in the first marriage. Oh, yeah, they
Marguerite.
Did.
Oh, yeah, he left her for an 18-year-old blonde girl.
No, but weren't they? But they
and
were
also
going
they had
divorce.
A child that died.
Right, he had, but they don't barely talk about it.
Well, I mean, I don't think
there's
Marguerite
a lot of
was giving interviews.
No, yeah. Marguerite gives no interviews.
Yeah, I'm not, I don't even know if she's alive.
Marguerite?
Yeah.
Marguerite?
Yeah.
Marguerite.
Yeah.
You had
Once
a party
more.
At your house, you served margaritas when you
That's
watched
what
the OJ
I'm thinking
doc,
of. Thank
which
you
was
so
in
much.
Bad taste.
2 weeks ago, we did Mexican night.
You
Me
and Risa.
My friend Risa Klein, who is, I mean, she is fun.
She doesn't have natural rhythm.
She brought over.
She likes to dance, but she's not a dancer.
She's so funny. She brought over those little...
I'm a dancer. I don't like to dance.
Little umbrellas, and I said, you don't put those in margaritas.
I believe you said she brought limaritas over.
Oh, yeah.
Budweiser limaritas? Was that not what it was?
Yeah. We had a good time. You got to enjoy your life. Life is short. It moves pretty fast.
So, Julie...
If you don't stop...
Let me ask you this, because you have such a fun pair of shoes on.
Look around.
Are you
going
to take a little vacation after any of this?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Do you ever
sure.
think about traveling? I know you're such a New Yorker. You have that oxymoron New York mentality, which is that you're so worldly and so interested in the world, but you don't go anywhere.
Yeah. Well, what can I say? If you go away somewhere, you should invite me along.
Why not?
Oh, I don't
like
traveling alone.
I mean, I don't think
alone.
That's a way to approach this.
I think it's nice to take a trip with friends.
Yeah, but
who, I also don't want
to
impose
like to
on friends
with?
Who are in couples. Like, it's a little...
Oh, it's not an imposition to those people. They can't stand each other.
Maybe.
They have to spend every night together.
You mean to say, like, take a break from your husband and let's go away?
Well, that's an option. And the other option is come away with us.
That's
who cares?
A three-way, recipe.
Julie, in 3 weeks...
I don't think it is.
Ray and I are going to Mohegan Sun. And if you'd like to join us, we can get a room
That's a recipe for a three-way. Weren't you just complaining that you had never had a three-way? Backstage, Beverly, when I was saying...
That's actually true.
I hear everything.
That's true.
You were saying, I've never had a three-way. And I would take one from anyone that would offer one.
Julie.
But you didn't specify
Julie, don't listen to her.
What if they were related?
Don't listen to her.
If it was like a
First
father
of all,
and a daughter.
Ray and I make love very quietly, and we wouldn't bother you. We weren't even there. We'll get a sofa with a pullout in our room at Mohegan Sun. He has comps.
What does a comp get you at Mohegan Sun?
A room with a pullout couch.
My first thought was a snow cone or an Italian ice.
Look, I'm not going to say that people really enjoy his company there at the blackjack table, but they do, because Ray knows how to play. He doesn't screw up the whole table the way some people do, and he's not a cooler, okay?
I am a cooler, that's
yes,
true.
Yes, you are. You look I at am. Me with such judgment.
I can't
stand it, Roy.
And Beverly and I have been to the tables together in Vegas, because I don't gamble. So I just want to shop or go to Nobu or whatever it is.
Makes me insane.
And I always am impatiently waiting for Beverly. One more hand. And I always cool it for her. It's true.
Well, you cool it for me. And then you stick a goddamn dime in some giant slot machine for fun and win
$10,000. Oh, that was fun.
Anyway,
I paid for dinner.
Anyway, Julie, is there anything that you want to say other than Difficult People, which we know and we're all looking forward to on July 12th on Hulu? They all drop at once or just a few episodes?
There's two episodes that are released the first week, and then the second week there's going to be a very exciting episode.
Can I give people my Hulu hack?
No.
Why not?
Because they should buy it. or sit through the ads, which are unfortunately abundant, but they are free.
Okay.
It is free if you watch it on the site,
no,
I think.
No, it's not. But it doesn't matter.
It's not?
Nope.
No, it is. And then if you get Hulu Plus, you don't have to watch it.
I think it's like the episode of the week you can watch for free.
Whatever. Spend your goddamn money. You can afford to live in New York City. You can afford to watch Hulu.
That often happens.
That was a real...
There's often a reversal with
that. That was a very enthusiastic... Yes.
Once she's had a few seconds to think about it, she changes her opinion sometimes.
Not me. I know I'm going to use my hack. But everyone else, if you're here tonight, then you can stick your hand in your pocket for someone who's trying to make you laugh. Anyway, so July 12th, what else can we look forward to? There's going to be a lot of interviews and fun things. Aren't you going to be like interviewed on like Jimmy Kimmel or whatever?
Jimmy Kimmel's not reached out.
Nope. Okay. So what are we going to see you on?
Well, maybe after this he will.
Are you going to be?
I'm sure he's a huge
I'll be here
listener
and there.
To the Ronna and Beverly podcast. It seems like his sort of
he's
thing.
He's a huge
Can
fan.
Can I say, is it too weird to say who's on the second week that it releases or no?
What? Who?
The guest stars on the second
on the
episode,
second episode,
the second week. The
same. What do I care who's on it?
I mean, who cares?
This woman named Chelsea Dunn, and these two gals named Jessica Chaffin and Jamie Denbo. And they're in a really
funny, heard of any of those people.
Very funny episode. And
I think you call that a guest, not a guest star.
They are.
I think it's
they
a
are
guest star
they are
when
guest
you've heard of
stars,
them.
And it's. Yeah. One of my favorite episodes, and I think you'll enjoy it.
You'll be the judge.
Anyway,
I think we should thank the people at the Green Space for having us.
Who at the Green Space?
That's where we are.
What's the Green Space?
That's where we are.
No.
WNYC.
No.
Work It. What do you mean, no?
That's not what this place is called. It's 44 Charlton. Jerome Building.
No, it's the Jerome L. Green Performance Space.
Oh, I don't know.
What?
You got the Uber.
We only traveled a block in it.
I didn't want to walk. It's New York.
We should thank the people at the WNYC Work It Festival for having
beep,
us
beep, 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 beep.
We were so honored and thrilled to be a part of it, and if it wasn't for Julie giving us our start, we never would have been. They have been so generous with us. Thank you to the fabulous Julie Klausner. If you have not seen her show, you must. You must. If you enjoy laughing. And to our wonderful guests, and by guests, I mean the audience.
Wait, I also want to thank Sam, the engineer.
That was fun.
Not Sam, my old flame? You don't want to thank Sam, my old flame?
I have to tell you, Sam, you're wearing your wristband from last night. Have you been home?
I have, yeah.
All right, I can't.
Well, and I don't... Part two, what is home?
And so
that we don't have time for. If it's anything like what happened to Cody with the guy behind the dumpster, I can't... Yeah.
Okay, and I'd like to thank... We'd like to also, because this will be broadcast on the Earwolf Network, we'll thank Earwolf, Michael Costantini.
Trim Costantini.
Oh, is he cute, Trim Costantini. You can't even imagine this guy.
But I want to thank our fabulous fans. Many people who are here today were out last night for the shows. Yeah. And if you didn't... And Zach A. with the flourish of the fan... If you guys didn't listen, we wouldn't have a show. We're so thrilled that you listened to us jibber a jabber on over and over again.
And also, I just want to say, Julie, you created a lot of this.
We already said that four times.
Did you know that Julie Klausner was the one who helped us get a podcast? Is that funny?
Better to say it too many times than not enough.
Namaste. It's a full circle.
Thank you for having us.
Yeah.